Hey guys, it's Ashley here, and today's topic is a little tougher, and I felt like it was only appropriate to share with you because I know so many people go through this, and I've actually had a lot of questions about it these last couple days. So the topic is how to discuss with your children on losing a family pet. It's a little tough, but I'm gonna do my best. And again, this is just my experience so far and how it's worked out for us. So our dog, we had him for 10 years. He was amazing. And I have a 4-year-old boy and a 2-year-old girl. Obviously, she adjusts a little better because her memories are so short of him, but she still looks for him. My 4-year-old, on the other hand, has a lot of questions. He was sad, but now it's just questions, and he's kind of at a point where he's moving on and wanting another. But I just thought I would tell you, and I feel like maybe this, how we handled it, helped him. Now I know some people aren't fortunate enough, I guess that's the terms I'm looking for, of foreseeing this event. I know sometimes it can be all of a sudden. We kind of foreseen this coming. It was a very rapid decline. So we felt, with knowing my son's personality, it was best to prepare him for this. So what we did is we prepared him that he was getting old. I know he's only 10, but he aged very rapidly. He had a lot of some issues that transpired over the last couple years that just kind of spun out of control. So we prepared him that he was getting older and that he would have to go to a place where old animals go and that they will be happy and healthy with Jesus. So obviously we are faith-based, so that is how we have explained it. You know, he's shown a lot of symptoms, so we were able to show him that he was sad, he was hurting, he was miserable, and that passing over, you know, to heaven was the best thing for him. He had a lot of questions about not seeing him, and that we would have pictures, and I reassured him. An amazing friend has passed on to us an amazing book. I have not opened it, as it has been gifted to the children and we will read it to them. But there were some tough questions. And I think the toughest for me, I mean, I think it's good to be emotional and it's okay to be sad for a while and it will pass. But what was hard for me is him asking me and questioning how Zeus was 10 and old, and I saw the worry on his face about, well, daddy's older than that. And it's just a tough thing, and we tried to explain it to him, but he seems to have grasped it appropriately. I think it's just harder for us because it has been 10 years of routines and memories. But I have found that it is best to just be very honest with them and truthful and simple. We don't need to go into great details with them. Keep it basic, light, and I think turning it into a positive thing is very important. So a lot of you have asked me how we are coping and what about the children. So I just wanted to share that with you. They are doing better. It's just us that are struggling with it. But again, even, you know, our son has reassured us that he is happy now with Jesus, and which is very true. But so I feel like, you know, having never been experienced this, as a nurse's point of view, I was always the one giving the bad news, not receiving it. This is our first time experiencing this kind of loss. So I think it was important due to the questions that I have received from friends and family regarding the children that I would share it with you. And so my advice would be to just keep it simple, be truthful, and educate them a little bit. And I think it's important to find the positive in it. So again, I know that's a really tough topic, but I've had a lot of, I was surprised at the amount of questions I've had about it, which only makes sense because I have never been on this end of it and experienced it for myself. So again, as I say and tell everybody, this too shall pass, and it's life. So again, I hope that's helpful to you. My heart breaks for anybody that's experienced it because it is hard. But everything works out. So again, I just recommend everybody just keeping it simple, truthful, and, you know, keeping it very positive. So again, that is kind of our experience with explaining losing a pet with children. Again, my children are 4 and 2, so it probably is a little more simple. But again, my 4-year-old had many, many questions. He is wanting to be very factual, and they are sponges. So I think it's very appropriate and necessary to be honest with them. So again, today's topic was tough, but it is in regards to our children, and what do you do when you lose a pet?